Hi, it's WolfensNormanCastle.com. Excuse me. And here on YouTube, you know me as Epic Fantasy. And this is my latest tutorial. This is part four of the Storm the Castle diorama. We make progress with this thing. We're starting to do some things. I'll bring the camera in. You can get a little bit of a closer look. But what we're doing here is we're starting to add details like the brickwork. Flesh out the building so they have the details, right? And stuff like that. This black paint is just a base coat. The final castle won't be black, but we need that base coat underneath any colors that we put over it. A lot of fun. We're almost all set with the design and layout of the castle. A few more details to work out. We've also gone ahead and plastered this part of it. Because in the previous tutorial, we plastered the terrain over there. Now we've plastered under the castle to get that all ready to set up the castle. So this tutorial, I'll show you some of the things that we've done and how we've done it. But first, I will we'll launch into the introduction, and I'll show you a little bit of close-up of what we've got going on here. Dioramas, origami, catapults, and treasure chests, telescopes, terrariums, bonsai trees, and paper games, swords and shields, and real blacksmithing, metal boxes, animation. I teach the art of real creation. StormTheCastle.com. Let's make something. Okay, let's unlock this project. See, the details are starting to come out, the well and the different buildings and the fortress, the keep. So you're starting to do the stonework. The stairwell looks nice. Can you see the stairwell? Hey, you want to do a big diorama? Do one. Just put the time in and don't rush it. Take your time. Okay, this part of the series of videos is all about building up the castle and getting it ready, doing some of the detail work. So in the previous video, we had made the rough shapes of all the buildings. Now we're starting to do the detail work and starting to assemble the stuff together. See, and with this foam is wonderful because you can use a pen to get all the textures out of it, the different rocks and shingles like this. See the shingles on the roof? Like that, and the various rocks and blocks in the walls and stuff like that. So we're getting those buildings into shape. And we're always conscious of the scale of it, right? So we're always checking against our figures to make sure we get it right. Doorways are the right size and windows are the right size. So you mark them off and cut them out. Some of them will get cut out, some of them don't. Some of them are faux doors and windows and stuff like that. And say we'll do some stonework here. See how the pen works really well on this? The important thing isn't the black pen. It's actually the indentation of the pen by pressing down in the foam. That's the important thing. Because it's going to get painted over. Cutting out the windows and doorways. And see how that window has a large slab of stone under it and a large slab of stone over it? So now we're having a lot of fun. This is starting to come together. It's starting to actually look like a castle. You know, this is part four. You can watch the other parts. And lots of different tools work well for this, even a Dremel. Now we have a whole section over here on the left. That's the castle setup, and it has a base plate under it, so the castle components can be built on it. And that has like courtyards and a wishing well. So we're doing the cobblestones and the stones in that too, just like that. We're going to show you a little bit more about that in a second. Over there on the left, all of that, that's all where the castle is. So let's clean it off and we're going to prepare that surface for plaster cloth. And this is wonderful plaster cloth, real wide like this. You can get this on Amazon. But typically I use the shorter sheets, the thinner sheets. But the biggest sheets here are great for terrain like this and big swaths of it. So you just soak it in water briefly and then lay it out on your diorama to make the ground. It adds a little bit of texture, a little bit of variation in terrain because that foam is awfully flat. We don't want it that perfectly flat. We want it to be a little bit varied. So we covered most of the land here in the castle side. All underneath the castle, we don't need it because that's got its own little base. Once that's painted up and texture is added to it, that's going to look great. Texture, some plants, some grass, and stuff like that. You'll see, I'll be getting to that. It's a pretty ambitious diorama. It's a pretty big one. It's a lot of work, but I think it's going to come out pretty good. So now there's the whole castle base, and we've looked at that before. We've got everything figured out, where all the components go, how it's all laid out, so we can go ahead and secure it in place. So we're going to glue it right down to the base of the to the surface of the table so we can put it together. Right, some regular glue, some hot glue, get it secured nicely. Then put some books on it to weigh it down while it dries. Now all that courtyard area where all the castle parts are, that's got detail work to do, like the water well. Which is very important. I tried to stick to a real castle with all of this, the various components. The portcullis and the main gate and the murder holes and, you know, the fortress. All this is indented well, so it will show up when painted. And we put our base coat of black down. The purpose for this is to get the black into the all the creases, just like in the castle parts. So let's take a little bit more, another look at a little bit more of the various details that we're doing. We're starting to do the crenellations that go around the various castle walls, all out of foam, and those are stone too. Then we cut a notch in them like this that comes right out, and then that can go on the castle wall to form the battlement. See that? And I'll show you that right now. There's the wall. The crenellations go right on that, so you've got a really nice, the way it sticks out, it looks really good. And there's still a walkway behind it on top of the wall. And that will get painted black too. Next is putting it all together. We got all the various parts. We got some detail work done on them. We start to glue this whole castle section together. And at the end of this video, in about another minute, we're going to take a look at that. I'll show you how it's all come together. It's almost all painted, but not all painted. The pieces are almost all together. We're pretty much at the completion of this stage. So you glue the various parts together because we had worked all of this out before. See? Gonna be something. Behind the castle is some rugged terrain with some hills. And to do that, we use the same method we used for the other terrain. Just crumple up some newspaper, cover a plaster cloth. And it looks like a rocky section, see? There's one, there'll be another one behind the castle. And I just wanted to say, at this point now, we're fixing all our foam. Getting rid of any imperfections. There's a groove in the top of that, so a little bit of plastic cloth seals that right up now, so nice, and flattens it out. So that's just about it. Thanks for watching. More of this coming. We're going to take this all the way through. I got to put lights on it and water and, well, a lot. Figures are being painted and all of that. We put all the pieces, various castle pieces together, and let's take a look at where it currently stands right now here. There you go. Starting to take shape. She had a wonderful courtyard and then an inner courtyard that's a little bit at a higher level, right? With the water well and then the steps up to the fortress or the keep, which is the last line of defense. The various towers, the little walkway, the walls, the stables, the smithy. And we'll get more look at that. The main gate. Thanks for watching. Lots more stuff on our website at stonycastle.com. Here's some more stuff for you.